at the HIE in Ragfurth, and I'm here with Peter Lambrex from Kaneka. And Kaneka are highlighting the benefits of ubiquinol and some of the emerging potential in that regard. Can you briefly tell me some of the things that are happening in this area, Peter?
Yes, CoQ10, especially in its active form ubiquinol, has already been long known in more the medical markets where doctors and pharmacists recommend the product, and also in the mass market. New fields we have seen now recently is the sports market, where we actually think ubiquinol has the same potential as carnitine in physical performance enhancement. And this has recently been shown in a study with German top Olympic athletes, where we could show a physical performance enhancement compared to placebo. And this was in an area where top experts say this is the difference between like a top 10 top 10 position and a medal position. So the sports market is one of the areas where we see a further expansion. And if I may, another one is, I must say also, we continue to convince the existing CoQ10 scientists and CoQ10 users about the benefits of ubiquinol as a better form of CoQ10. So we certainly still see expansion possibilities in that part also.
There was recently a conference held in Seville where some of these issues were addressed. Can you tell me some of the emerging science within the coenzyme Q10 space?
Yes, that's very interesting. Fields have been shown in Sevilla. So before that, it was also in, like in Japan, Kobe and so on. In Sevilla, the global scientists, the most interesting studies were in ubiquinol. There was a reconfirmation of some high-ranking journals that showed that there is a fertility benefits of ubiquinol, so infertile men if they take ubiquinol. So that has also been confirmed by other groups, not only Iran but other markets. We've seen in like the medical field like fibromyalgia, nice results, chronic fatigue syndrome, autism, very interesting, promising results being shown on the conference. And also in the anti-aging, we already know ubiquinol is a very good substance for anti-aging. We've now seen that one of the mechanisms, plausible mechanisms accepted by the anti-aging experts is on the sirtuin and PGC1 genes, that ubiquinol is enhancing these genes in a good direction, and which is possibly a way that can explain anti-aging. And that's all been also discussed on this recent scientific conference in Sevilla.
How close are you to obtaining health claims, or what are your plans from that regard?
We are working on a concept. It's not easy because, you know, one of the simple things, and glucosamine is the example, if you take studies on patients, they cannot be used in this part of the world, in Europe, to support health claims. So we really have now to look around what are the golden design trials that needs to be done in specific health claims. So we are working on that, and we are further expanding on that. But as I maybe said before, this is not a fast-moving consumer electronics. You really need to really check out and you need to explain the professors in Europe. Hey, you may be a professor, you may have your nice opinion, but we want health claims, and for this, EFSA is becoming the reference, not you. So we are working on that, getting the golden design protocols, and then move on and do the trials, and then submit the dossier, and expect and hopefully get also the EFSA approval. But this just takes time, 12, 24 months, 36 months.
That the timeline that you have in mind, basically? Probably about 2 years.
You need to get the protocol, do the subjects, get the subjects, make sure the subjects on medication, they are really a good cohort for the studies. So that's what you need to do. You also need a dossier. The theory says it takes 9 months, 12 months to get the really approval from EFSA after you submit the dossier. So these are the things
which would be the first claim that you might assess?
We're working on that. We know that's we would like to keep in-house for the time being. But it will not be a proprietary claim, because Kaneka has like 50 or 70 patents in the ubiquinol field as a substance. So we will not have it like an unpublished claim. We will, I think, after the trial, share around the results. I'm confident.
Peter, thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.